Manandali ang itinigil ang Senate hearing tungkol sa war on drugs matapos na magkainitan si former President Rodrigo Duterte nang tanungin ni Senator Risa Ontiveros kung handa ba siyang panagutan ang pagkamatay ni Kian De Los Santos at iba pang biktima ng extrajudicial killings na una nang sinabi ni Duterte na I take full responsibility para sa war on drugs. Nagtulungan naman si Senator Bato de la Rosa, Senator Bongo at Senator Robin Padilla upang patotohanan ang talamak na droga noong hindi pa nakaupo bilang Pangulo si former President Rodrigo Duterte. Nagpakita rin sila ng positibong suporta sa dating Pangulo sa kabila ng mga negatibong batikos patungkol sa AGK sa Pinas. Narito ang buong detalye. Ngunit bago tayo magpatuloy, huwag kalimutang i-like, share, subscribe and click the notification bell for more updates and for more upcoming videos. Maraming salamat.
Good morning, everyone. Mr. Chair, truth-telling needs no dressing up for the occasion. Telling the truth demands nothing more than just that. Telling it, testifying to it. Lying, on the other hand, requires fabrication. Intricate, deliberate, elaborate planning. One lie is tied to a system, an entire web of other lies, in order for the story, the fabric, to hold together. Nitong nakaraang mga araw, Mr. Chair, ako'y tinanong kung ano raw ang mga ginagawa kong preparasyon para sa pagdinig natin ngayong araw na ito. Ang sagot ko po ay wala. Sapagkat ang pagsasabi ng totoo ay hindi humihingi ng anumang espesyal na paghahanda. Ang katotohanan, bali-baligtarin man simula sa dulo o sa gitna, ay masasabi ng malaya sa kalooban. Sasabihin naman ng iba, ganun naman pala, bakit hindi ka nalang umattend doon sa hearing ng House? My position on this to has remained the same. I do not wish to be the first to break our tradition of interparliamentary courtesy. If our counterparts in the lower house do not exercise interparliamentary courtesy, this humble representation does. But most importantly, I do not wish to be a guest of their gag show. Mr. President, kung ako ay makasarili lamang, kung ako ay swapang na tao, unang pagtawag pa lang nila, nandun ako mag-attend to clear myself. But because I am a member of the Senate, I have to protect the tradition that is being observed by this institution. Kaya hintayin na lang nila, Mr. President, pag hindi na ako senador, I will be there every day. Kung gusto po na, doon ako tumira sa kanila. Pero sa ngayon, ako ay senador pa, please naman, sana respetuhin nila yung ating interparliamentary courtesy. Ayaw kong magiging presidents, Mr. President. Pagdating ng araw, in the future, lahat ng mga senador na mabubwisit sa kakatawag sa kanilang pangalan kapag ang kanilang pangalan ay na-implicate sa investigation na ginagawa ng other house, ay punta na lang ng punta at wala na magawa na legislation. Kaya po ako naririto ngayon, hindi lamang bilang isang vice chairperson ng committee ito, kundi bilang isang resource person. As a former chief, PNP chief during the Duterte administration, I have been tagged multiple times as the face of the war on drugs. The same war on drugs openly supported by both the Senate and the House of Representatives and of course supported by our people. Perhaps I am one of the best persons to contribute to today's discussion. I am here, Mr. Chair, to tell the truth and as I do so, witness the web of lies come undone, one thread at a time. Today, I say duty calls. My duty to the truth and nothing but the truth. So help me God. Daghang salamat, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator De La Rosa. The chairman apologizes for forgetting our tradition here in the Senate that the Senate officers, when they are present, they are given priority in line, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen. So, let me now recognize our Senate President Pro Tempore Senator Estrada if he cares to deliver his opening statement.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Good morning, Mr. Chair, my esteemed colleagues, and to all our resource persons, particularly former President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. First and foremost, I would like to commend this subcommittee for its immediate action to discuss this pressing issue that has shaped our nation's landscape, the Philippine War on Illegal Drugs. The War on Illegal Drugs campaign, which was started to fight the drug problem that jeopardizes our community's safety and well-being, has generated a lot of discussion about its strategies and ramifications. Hindi mapagkakaila na ang inisyatibong ito ay nagpalawak ng kamalayan ng publiko hinggil sa malaking problema sa illegal na droga at sa mga panganib na dulot nito na nagbunsod ng mas mataas na pag-iingat sa ating mga komunidad. Habang kinikilala natin ito at ang pangangailangan at tugunan ang mga krimeng may kaugnayan sa illegal na droga, mahalaga rin na isa-alang-alang ang mga karapatang pantao at dignidad ng lahat ng individual na apektado. Let's approach this issue with an open mind and a commitment to identifying a policy that genuinely benefits the Filipino people. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Senator Estrada. Next would be our majority leader, Senator Tol Tolentino.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, before I proceed with my opening statement, just a point of parliamentary inquiry. Are we now using, because I used to be the chairman of the Blue Ribbon Committee, and we amended the rules last year, August 17, 2023, to be exact. Are we now adopting the amended rules of the Blue Ribbon, Mr. Chairman?
To answer the question of the majority leader, we are, of course, operating under the new rules of the Blue Ribbon, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The reason why I asked the question is that because our jurisdiction is embodied in the new set of rules, the purpose of which is to define the limits of our power and how and for what purpose that power is to be used. Having said that, Mr. Chairman, I thank you for adopting the said rules. Gusto ko lamang pong idiin sa mga nakikinig po ngayon, lalong-lalo na po sa mga abogadong naririto, that you should have in your possession or you must have probably read the rules that I have just mentioned. Otherwise, siguro yung mga kliyente nyo, hindi dapat kayo bayaran ngayon kung hindi nyo nabasa yung rules. No offense to the members of the bar present here, Mr. President. Mr. President, I have been studying meticulously long lines of cases, and it would appear that the moras here, Mr. President, of congressional, this Senate hearing's motivation is probably understandable. There is indeed, to the minds of those knowledgeable in law, a seeming conflict between a presumption of regularity as to what this committee will be doing and the presumption of innocence insofar as the rights of those perhaps not yet indicted resource persons present here today. Mr. Chairman, balancing the general public interest as against individual rights is probably the duty of this committee, and that is your job today, Mr. Chairman. In proceeding with today's investigation, I have studied the long line of constitutional authority emanating from the Constitution to the recognition by the Constitution itself of the right of the House of Representatives or the Senate to formulate its own rules. And under our rules, a Blue Ribbon Committee was indeed established. And a Blue Ribbon Committee, just like any other committee, can delegate the functions of the said committee to a subcommittee. And that is what we are doing right now, Mr. Chairman, if I'm not mistaken. The presumption of regularity is there. The constitutional chain of authority having been established is there. But what is now needed, Mr. Chairman, is for the committee to really, as what the Senate President pro tempore mentioned a while ago, exercise and allow that the word respect should permeate the proceedings today, Mr. President. Dapat po magkaroon ng paggalang sa isa't isa habang tinatalakay natin ang nilalaman, ang konteksto ng ating hearing ngayon. Meron lamang po kung gustong idagdag, Mr. Chairman, na most probably hindi pa nagagamit. And I'm now addressing my colleagues here, the members of the bar, lawyers here in attendance. When a resource person is asked and he refuses legally not to answer a question, he can invoke the right against self-incrimination. That is provided for under the Constitution. That is legal. But we have a case, Mr. President, Mr. Chairman, which should now be incorporated under our rules, that before a resource person can be declared cited in contempt, that he or she be given the right to explain why he or she should not be cited in contempt. That was part of the latest Supreme Court dicta in the Ong case. Number two, and this has not yet been raised in all investigations that I have attended ever since. There is a second, and I'm now aiding the lawyers here in attendance, that there is a second right that can be invoked by a resource person in refusing to answer a question. And that right would sound something like this: I refuse to answer the question because this is not pertinent to the inquiry under consideration. Mr. Chairman, the word inquiry is part of our rules. That is Section 3, wherein a jurisdictional challenge can be raised. Questions should be pertinent or relevant to the inquiry. That has never been raised, and in a long line of decided cases in other jurisdictions, refusal to answer a question on the said ground has been sustained. Mr. President, I raise that point because, first, before I again proceed with my opening statement, pinasasalamatan po natin si Pangulong Duterte sa pagpapaunlak sa imbitasyon ng committee ito, ng subcommittee ito, para ipaliwanag yung mga dapat ipaliwanag. Kinikilala po namin ang inyong karapatan. Kinikilala rin po ng committee ito ang karapatan ng lahat na naririto, at dapat po yan igalang. The Senate's power to investigate is not merely a procedural exercise. It is a profound duty that enables us to uncover the truth, foster transparency, and safeguard public trust. Yet, in our pursuit of the truth, we are guided by the unyielding principles of the Bill of Rights, a cornerstone of our democracy that protects the freedoms and dignity of every Filipino. Yun po yung sinabi ko kanina. Mahirap yung trabaho ng chairman dito ng committee ito to balance public interest as against individual rights. The Bill of Rights ensures that even as we seek accountability, no individual rights to due process, protection from self-incrimination, nor presumption of innocence is compromised. These rights are not obstacles to the truth, but essential safeguards that uphold justice and strengthen our commitment to the rule of law. As we carry our investigative duties today, which is a broad information gathering given possible future legislative measures, let us reaffirm that truth can only be pursued within the framework of respect for these fundamental freedoms. By doing so, we not only fulfill our mandate but honor the democratic principles that protect our people. Maraming salamat po, Senator Pimentel. Maraming salamat sa Blue Ribbon Committee.
Thank you, Majority Leader, for the words of wisdom. We now go back to the list. Senator Risa Ontiveros, if she wishes to give her opening statement. Thank
you. Yes, salamat kaayo, Mr. Chair. Magandang umaga po. Nagpapasalamat ako sa ating chair dahil una nating maririnig ang kwento ng mga biktima at naulila ng war on drugs. Their stories deserve to be heard and should spur us to action. Mga kababayan, dati walang kagatol-gatol na nangako si President Rodrigo Duterte na papatayin niya ang kapwa niya Pilipino. Mga ama, ina, anak, magkakapamilya at magkakapitbahay, mga journalist, mga kritiko, alang-alang sa baluktot na pagkakaintindi niya sa kaayusan at kapayapaan. Yan ang isa sa mga pangako niyang sana hindi na lang niya tinupad. Maraming nagsasabi, nagbibiro lang daw si tatay. Pero sa ngayon, hindi tayo nandito para magtalo pa kung anong ibig niyang sabihin sa libo-libong beses na sinabi ni President Duterte na papatayin niya tayong mga Pilipino. Today, we will take him at his word. Ngayong umaga, iimbestigahan natin ang madugong war on drugs at ang mga batas at polisiya na nagpahintulot dito. Malaking bagay po ang partisipasyon ni dating Pangulong Duterte bilang chief architect ng giyerang ito. Kulang ang anumang imbestigasyon kung hindi siya tatanungin. Ngunit, hindi ito tungkol lang sa kanya dahil bawat biktima ng EJK at mga naulila nila ay biktima ng sistematikong pang-aabuso. In the end, the perpetrators were even rewarded. Pare-pareho ang resulta ng imbestigasyon. May organized kill list, summary executions, may mga alegasyon ng planted na ebidensya, hanggang sa nabalot na ng takot ang mga barangay natin. Mga nanlaban daw kasi yan, sabi ng ating mga pulis. Kung kampanya talaga ito laban sa droga, bakit tinatayang 122 na bata ang napatay kabilang ang isang taong gulang na sanggol na walang kamuwang-muwang? Nanlaban? Yung 32 na namatay sa Bulacan sa loob ng iisang gabi noong 2017, lahat ba yon nanlaban? Talaga? Eh yung 26 kataong patay sa isang gabi rin noong 2017 sa Maynila naman, nanlaban. Para sa maraming biktima, hindi madali ang manindigan para sa kanilang mga karapatan. Kaya sa kasagsagan ng war on drugs noong 2017, hinawakan ng aking opisina ang kaso ni Kian De Los Santos at kinupkup namin ang mga testigo sa kanyang pagpatay, kasama ang mga menor de edad. Nawa, sa pamamagitan ng hearing na ito, masimula ng pagkamit ng hustisya at paghihilom para sa kanila at sa iba pang biktima. At sa lahat ng nagsasabi na ang war on drugs ay parusa daw para sa mga naliligaw ang landas, my message to you is this: there is no honor in punishment like tokhang. It should not be an honor to be called the punisher when thousands of innocent people, including babies, have died in your name. Hindi kailanman ipagmamalaki ng mga Pilipino ang war on drugs na yan. Nagan salamat, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. Senator Padilla is next. Senator Bongo waived his prioritization. Okay, you're next, Senator Padilla. Then I'll go back to Senator Bongo.
Maraming salamat po. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Bismillahi wa salatu wa salamu Allah Rasulillahi. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Isa pong pagbati ng kapayapaan sa inyong lahat. Unang-una po sa amin pong tagapangulo, Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, Pinunong Minorya Aquilino Coco Pimentel III. Mga magandang umaga po. At sa amin pong pro tempore, Senator Jinggo Estrada. Sa amin pong Majority Leader, Francis Tol Tolentino, sir. At sa amin pong Deputy Minority Floor Leader, Senator Risa Ontiveros. At siyempre po, sa amin pong pinakamatigas na Senador, Senator Bato de la Rosa. At sa amin pong malasakit King, Senator Go. At sa lahat po ng mga bisita, at siyempre po sa Iron Man, ang hinahangaan po naming pinakamagaling na Pangulo ng Pilipinas, PRRD, Digong, Mayor, isang magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Ako po ay nakikinig sa mga opening statement ng aking mga kasama. Sila po ay mga Batikan na senador, mga abogado, mga kilala na po na nagbibigay ng point of view sa legal na usapin. Ang akin pong pahayag ay naratibo ng isang convicted criminal. Ako po ay convicted. Ako po ay nakulong. Ako po ay nabuhay kasama ang mga kriminal sa Bilibid. At kilala ko po ang underworld. Siguro po, maaring sa ibang bagay, mas maraming nalalaman ang aking mga kasamang senador. Pero pag pinag-usapan po natin ang mga kriminal dito sa bayan natin, ako po ang magsasabi sa inyo, napakadami na pong kriminal sa atin na walang puso, ang mga halang ang kaluluwa. Napag-usapan po natin ang mga biktima ng sinasabing war on drugs, pero hindi po natin napag-usapan ang mga biktima ng mga durugista. Kung paano pinapatay ang kanilang mga anak, pinapatay ang kanilang mga asawa, pinapatay ang kanilang kapitbahay. Kung paano sinira ng droga ang mga buhay ng mga pamilya ng OFW. Kung paano po sa loob mismo ng Bilibid, kung saan po ako nakulong ng 3 taon at ginawa ko pang pelikula ito, ang pangalan po ng pelikula, maaaring niyo pong panoorin, Hari ng Selda, dito po ay ibinunyag ko na nasa loob mismo ng Bilibid ay nagluluto ng shabu. 1998 po yun. Kung bibilangin po natin yung taon na yun, hanggang sa dumating ang Iron Man, ilang taon po yun. Ganun po kahaba ang mga panahon na namayani at talagang naghahari ang mga drug pusher sa Bilibid. Alam niyo po, mga mahal kong kababayan, wala po, totoo po, ang kamatayan ng buhay ng isang tao ay yan po ay bigay ng Diyos. Yan po ay kayamanan, yan po ay regalo sa atin ng Diyos. Pero, mga mahal kong kababayan, ang ating pong bayan ay nasa bingit ng napakalaking kapahamakan. Kung hindi po tatitindig ang ating kapulisan, kung hindi po tatayo ang ating mga law enforcement, tayo po ay tatalunin ng mga sindikatong nag-ahari na nagluluto na ng mga droga kung saan-saan. Mga mahal kong kababayan, ang datos po ang magsasabi na nung sa panahon ni Pangulong Rodrigo Roa Duterte, masasabi ko na po na natakot ang mga kriminal. Wala pa po siyang ginagawa. Doon lang sa commercial niya na last Christmas yun na to, natakot na ho ang napakaraming kriminal. Natakot na ho ang napakaraming durugista, napakaraming pusher ang nag-surrender. Wala pong nangyayari. Sa salita lang po yun. Mga mahal kong kababayan, kung sisisi natin lahat ang mga namatay dito sa administrasyon ni Rodrigo Roa Duterte, abay, nagkakamali po tayo. Alamin po natin kung ano ang drug underworld, kung ano ang mga drug syndicates.
ako na po ang nagsasabi sa inyo. Regular na po ito tuwing magpapalit ng administrasyon, naglilinis ang mga sindikato. Magkakaroon talaga ng maraming mamamatay dahil naglilinis para pagpasok ng bagong administrasyon, eh yung kanilang mga alagang, mga kriminal, mga alagang, mga pusher, mga tapos na. Sana po, sa usapin na ito, maging realistic po tayo, mga mahal kong kababayan. Kung kailan ba natin na ibalik sa mga kababayan natin ang kalsada. Nung panahon na yon, nagiinuman sa tabi, nakahubad, ang mga babae hindi makapaglakad, hindi ka makapaglakad ng may cellphone ka, agawin ng cellphone mo, loob ng bahay mo, papasukin ka. Mga kababayan naman, huwag naman nating haluan ng politika ito. May mga bagay dito sa mundo na kailangan maging realidad tayo. Buong mundo, problema ang droga. Kung walang tatayo para lumaban dito, papano na ang kinabukasan ng mga anak natin? Papano na ang kinabukasan ng bayan natin? Kaya sana po ang inihiling ko sa lahat dito sa pagdinig na ito, iwasan ng politika at tingnan po natin kung saan talaga tayo tutungo ang bayan natin. Mga kababayan, lubog na po tayo sa utang, lubog pa tayo sa tubig. Pati ba naman sa ganito, lubog pa rin tayo. Yun lamang po, maraming salamat po.
Thank you, Senator Robin Padilla. So, Senator Bongo, please.
Salamat, Mr. Chair. Good day to all my esteemed colleagues and to all resource persons present here today. Allow me to begin by expressing my deepest condolences to the families of the victims of Typhoon Christine as well as those who lost their properties and livelihood. Please know that your Senate will be working extra hard to address your pressing concerns. Marami tayong gustong imbestigahan at bigyan ng pansin, lalo na po sa pangangailangan po ng mga nasalanta. Rest assured that your senators will do so at the proper forum. In the meantime, we are here to discuss another pressing issue that concerns not only the previous administration, but the future of our nation. Gusto ko pong lumabas na ang katotohanan para makafocus na po tayo sa pagserbisyo po sa ating mga kababayan. Lalo na ngayon, marami pong nasalanta na nangangailangan po ng tulong at ang daming naghihirap. With this, let me emphasize that everything I will say here will be on my oath as a senator. To be clear, my presence here is not only as a member of this committee but also as a resource person kung kinakailangan para maliwanagan tayong lahat. Andito tayo para malaman ang totoo. Nais nating lumabas ang katotohanan. After all, there is only one truth, and it can stand for itself, and there is no need to defend it. Mr. Chair, I trust that the truth will be thoroughly and fairly brought out by this committee, fittingly presided by our minority leader, Senator Coco Pimentel. We respect its mandate to investigate the war against illegal drugs in aid of legislation. In fact, I filed a resolution to investigate the war on drugs dahil gusto nating malaman ang totoo. Gusto nating makapagsalita ng malaya at na walang takot ang mga naimbitahan dito. Walang public shaming, walang trial by publicity, katotohanan lamang po at hindi politika. The Filipino people must realize the truth at kung ano ang naidulot ng kampanya laban sa illegal na droga at kung nakinabang ba ang mga Pilipino. Mr. Chair, bago mahalal si dating Pangulong Duterte, talamak talaga ang illegal na droga noon. Napasukan ito ng sindikato at karamihan dyan armado. Kahit ang hanay ng pulisya na infiltrate, systematic talaga ang problema. Kaya naman kinailangan po ng kamay na bakal para solusyonan ito. Kaya nga nanalo si dating Pangulong Duterte dahil sa kanyang campaign promise to get rid of illegal drugs, criminality and corruption na mga salot po ng lipunan. Mr. Chair, ang sambayan ng Pilipino na po ang humusga. Kung nakakapaglakad ba sila sa gabi na walang takot sa daan, pati po yung mga OFWs natin sa abroad, nagkakaroon ba sila ng peace of mind dahil ligtas ang mga mahal nila sa buhay na nakauwi po sa gabi na hindi nasasaktan at hindi nababastos. Nung panahon ng panunungkulan ni dating Pangulong Rodrigo Duterte, 55% o halos 6 sa bawat 10 barangay sa buong bansa ang naging drug-free. Resulta po ito ng pagkumpiska sa lampas 76 billion na halaga ng droga na pakalat-kalat noon sa ating mga lansangan. Base rin po sa datos, 79% o halos 8 sa bawat 10 Pilipino ang sumusuporta sa kampanya laban sa illegal na droga. Sa unang 5 taon naman ni Pangulong Duterte sa pwesto, mahigit 70% ang ibinaba ng crime rate sa buong bansa. Bukang bibig po yan ng ating mga kababayan kung gaano sila kapanatag lumabas sa lansangan kahit sa disoras ng gabi dahil alam nilang ligtas sila at ang kanilang mga anak. Ako mismo, meron po ako nakakasalubong sa mga 7-Eleven, nagpapasalamat na ligtas na raw po ang kanilang mga anak. Kaya naman po, nananatiling mataas ang approval at trust ratings ni Pangulong Duterte mula simula hanggang pagtatapos ng kanyang termino. Ito ang patunay na kinikilala ng sambayanan ang mga positibong pagbabagong dala ng kanyang pamamalakad. The war on drugs of the previous administration, lest we forget, enjoyed widespread public support across all sectors. Mr. Chair, hindi po natin maikakaila. People are now seeing the difference on how once upon a time they felt safe in the streets and their communities. Mr. Chair, nakakalungkot dahil bumaligtad na po ang panahon, nagbago na po ang ihip ng hangin, ang pinagsikapan at pinaghirapan po ng nakarang administrasyon na linisin ang bansa laban sa kriminalidad at droga, ganon-ganon na lang po ngayon kung baliwalain. Mr. Chair, ganon ba natin itrato ang sakripisyo ng mga alagad ng batas noon? Imbis na pasalamat tayo sa kanila at sila po'y naging bayani noon, sila po ngayon ay tila binabasura. Nung panahon ng war on drugs, panay-puri ang naririnig natin. Napakaganda po ang ginawa ni PRRD. Bakit makalipas po ng 3 taon, puro paninira at paninisi na? Paano naman po yung mga taong nagtrabaho at tumulong para maibalik ang peace and order? At paano rin po yung mga magagandang naidulot sa mga Pilipino ng laban kontra droga? But Mr. Chair, this does not mean that the Duterte administration sanctioned human rights abuses. Ang tanging hangarin ni dating Pangulong Duterte ay linisin ang ating bansa at labanan ang mga naghahasik ng lagim, lalo na po sa pagdating sa illegal na droga. Sa pagkakaalam ko, kailanman ay wala siyang ipinapatupad na anumang sistema, kapalit po ang buhay ng sinuman. Ayaw natin na mismong mga alagad ng batas ang lalabag sa karapatang pantaot at ayaw rin nating mangyari ang mga durugista ang maghahasik ng lagim sa bawat kalye na ating dinadaanan. Nung panahon ni dating Pangulong Duterte, kung malagay sa alanganin ang buhay ng mga pulis, kung manlaban ang sospek, unahan na nila dahil ayaw niyang pulis ang mamatay sa ginagawa lang naman nila ang kanilang tungkulin. In fact, noong 2018, sa maalala ko po, pumunta po kami ni dating Pangulong Duterte sa Norsagaray, alas 3 po ng umaga, sa burol po ng isang pulis na binaril po ng drug addict, naunahan po siya. Yan po ay isa sa mga halimbawa na nakakalungkot na ginagampanan po ng tungkulin ng ating kapulisan ng kanilang trabaho. Maliban sa paggawa ng batas, kailangan talaga ay taasan ang budget ng mga pulis para wala silang rason na hindi nila magampanan ang trabaho nila. Di ba, maalala nyo po, noong 2018, inuna nating idoble ang sahod ng pulis sa entry position nila, kasama na po dyan ang mga uniform personnel. Estudyante pa po ako, 1980s, 90s, takot na takot po ako sa pulis. Checkpoint, walang ilaw, maraming hulidap, laglag bala, extortion. Pero nung panahon ni Pangulong Duterte, na ibalik po ang respeto sa mga pulis. Kaya full support po tayo sa mga uniform personnel at lalong-lalo na po sa mga nagtatrabaho para sa bayan. Dagdag pa dyan, dapat bigyan natin sila ng sufficient operational support, legal support in line of duty. In fact, I filed Senate Bill 422 to provide free legal assistance for uniformed personnel who on any charge related to the performance of their official duty. Sakaling mang may arestuhin sila, meron silang operational funds o panggastos, kailangan talaga nilang suporta. Kulang talaga ang kanilang pondo. Paano naman sila makakagalaw kung abunado pa sila? Kaya po, nandito tayo in aid of legislation to craft laws and check if kailangan ng additional budget para magampanan nila ang tama ang kanilang tungkulin. Let me reiterate, my fellow legislators, I was once quoted in relation to PRRD's anger towards these ninja cops, no? Dahil full support nga po siya sa mga police, tapos meron pang mga ninja cops. Nag-imbestiga tayo dito mismo sa Senado. Natanong ako tungkol dito at sinabi ko, oo, galit talaga siya sa mga ninja cops. At dahil dito, tinakot niya talaga para ma-intimidate sila, para matakot po sila. Iba po ang pananakot para ma-intimidate at iba naman po ang usapan, ang reward. Alam ko, walang reward system na ipinapatupad si former President Duterte laban sa sinumang sibilyan, mapadrug lord man o karaniwang tao na sangkot sa illegal na droga. Walang basihan ang mga paratang na binitawan sa mga pagdinig na di umano'y reward system kapalit ang buhay noong panahon ng war on drugs ng Duterte administration. At habang nasa usapin tayo ng pera, taliwas po sa sinasabi ng iba, niminsan po, hindi po ako authorized, hindi ako humahawak ng pera. Sinasagot ko lang po ito dahil sa mga pagdinig, no, na nababanggit po ang ating pangalan, never po ako nag-handle ng budget of finance matters, kahit nung mayor pa po si Pangulong Duterte. Taliwas din po sa sinasabi ng iba. And in fact, maraming nadadamay, si Muking, who is not employed in the Senate, was a personnel in the office of the president noon, at tulad ko, scheduling, administrative work, mga clerical work, I'm sure lahat kayo nagpapa-appointment po sa amin through Muking noong unang panahon. Sobrang busy po yon, marami pong opisyal na lumalapit sa amin, at even during the time of the pandemic, no, nangailangan ng tulong at hindi po namin tinatanggihan yan sa abot ng aming makakaya, ay pinapansin po namin lahat ng hinaing. Nais ko rin klaruhin ang naging trabaho o role ko po sa administrasyon ni dating Pangulong Duterte. I was appointed and faithfully served as Special Assistant to the President or SAP from 2016 to 2018 as per Section 2 of Executive Order 2016-01 as SAP. I exercise mere oversight functions of three independent and cross-functional offices of which are OSAP, Office of the Appointment Secretary, and Presidential Management Staff. As stated in the executive order creating OSAP, our functions were limited to scheduling, appointments, and presidential engagements. Our mandate did not include sensitive matters like police operations. Walang kinalaman po ang aking opisina o sinumang staff nito noon sa operasyon at organisasyon sa government security sector, mapamilitary o kapulisan, whether directly or indirectly, we had no participation in these operations. In 2018, I left the executive branch when I resigned in order to run for and eventually be elected as senator in 2019 as a legislator and chairman of the Committee on Health during the time of COVID-19 pandemic. I supported and coordinated closely with the executive branch to be able to formulate policies and legislation that would improve our response to the pandemic. We passed Republic Act 11469 or the Bayanihan to Heal as One Law, Republic Act 11494 or the Bayanihan to Recover as One Law, and Republic Act 11712 or the Public Health Emergency Benefits and Allowances for Healthcare Workers Act, among others. Beyond my mandate as a senator, nangako po ako kay Pangulong Duterte na hindi ko po siya iwanan at lalay pa rin po ako sa kanya sa pangangailangan niya po in my own personal capacity. Kung kaya naman po, sinasamahan ko siya at kadalasan po ay sa personal ko po itong kapasidad. At lalong-lalo na po sa kanyang mga pangangailangan medical, lalo na po na tumatanda na siya, nagkakaedad na po si Pangulong Duterte at pangako ko sa kanya noon at hanggang ngayon ay hindi ko po siya pababayaan. I am one of the most accommodating persons. Alam niyo po yan. Bukas po ang aking opisina, kahit alas 12 ng gabi, pwede kayong tumawag sa akin. Karamihan po sa inyo, maging mga kasamahan natin sa lower house, ako po ang nakasanayang tawagan kung may gusto po silang iparating kay Pangulong Duterte kahit senador na po ako. Invitation sa birthday at lahat ng mga reklamo, pinapakinggan ko po yan. Siyempre, hindi ko naman alam ang lahat ng sagot sa mga reklamo. Kahit si former President Duterte, hindi niya rin po lahat alam sa lahat, sa dami po ng kanyang ginagawa. Kaya naman, kung may mga gustong magpa-verify ng mga information, maraming reklamo, scammers, manluloko, extortionists, we refer it to CIDG, NBI, doon tayo tumatawag para malaman ang information. Ito siguro ang tinutukoy ng mga ilang opisyal, no, including Police Colonel Leonardo, na sisikapin nating sisiyatin, no, dahil sa amin talaga lumalapit at humihingi ng tulong. Kahit sa nung nasa Office of the President pa ako, kapag may concerns or reports that are confidential in nature, pinapasa ko po yan sa kinauukulang ahensya. All reports na directed kay President Duterte, siya lang po ang pwedeng magbasa, classified information or documents ang tawag dyan. Ngayon, nandito po tayo para malaman kung may naging pang-aabuso ba sa hanay ng kapulisan at nagamit ba ito sa pansariling interest. With this information, we can then craft the necessary legislation to better serve our countrymen. As Chairman of the Committee on Health and Demography and Vice Chairperson of the Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs, we want to find ways to improve our continuing fight against illegal drugs through the creation of meaningful policies. As we know, the drug menace is also a health issue. Drug dependents should be treated as victims in dire need of medical, psychological, and spiritual help, with a chance of being successfully reintegrated into society as healthy and productive citizens. Para itong sakit sa lipunan na ayaw nating kumalat, kagaya ng kahit anumang sakit, importante po dito ang prevention at early detection. Maghanap po tayo ng paraan para hindi lumala at hindi malulong ang ating mga kababayan dito. Tulungan natin gumaling at magbagong buhay ang mga nalulong sa droga. The past administration had shown equal concern for the rehabilitation and reintegration of drug dependents by directing executive branch of the government to support the establishment of drug abuse treatment and rehabilitation centers. Meron pong mga rehabilitation centers na ipinatayo, umpisa pa lang po ng administrasyon ni dating Pangulong Duterte. Kasama na po dyan ang sa Bukidnon. Malaking tulong po si Senator Mig Subiri dyan, Nueva Ecija, and Las Piñas. Kaya lang po, sa kalagitnaan, hindi na po nagamit itong mga rehabilitation centers sa Nueva Ecija. Kalahati lang po ang na-occupy. Ang war on drugs ay dapat whole of government, whole of nation approach, kaya may rehabilitation at reintegration. In fact, former President Duterte issued Executive Order No. 4 creating an interagency task force for the establishment and support of drug abuse treatment and rehabilitation centers. We saw the biggest voluntary surrender of more than 1 million drug users and personalities, which is a feat that has never been seen in the country's history. Ang dami pong sumurrender noon kay then CPNP. 1.6 million po ang sumurrender. First 6 months po ito. Kulang na kulang nga po yung mga lugar, no, kung saan sila magsusurrender. Nagkulang po ang mga preso dahil sa dami po ng nagsurrender. Nagsurrender po sila dahil sa paniniwala nila na seryoso po ang war against drugs ni Pangulong Duterte. Bilang mambabatas, trabaho natin na suriin ang mga pulisiya laban sa droga noon at ngayon, at makagawa ng mga bagong batas na kinakailangan upang maisulong ang mga drug abuse prevention, mapagtibay ang law enforcement, masagip ang mga nabibiktima upang magbagong buhay, at mapalakas ang rehabilitation efforts. Bigyan po natin sila ng pagkakataon na magbagong buhay po. For my part, as early as 2019, I already filed a bill, Senate Bill 428, which would establish drug abuse treatment and rehabilitation centers in every province I also filed Senate Bill 2115 to have vocational and livelihood programs for rehabilitated drug dependents. Bilang chairman po ng Committee on Health, Sports and Youth, naniniwala po ko na isang health concern po na maaring matugunan sa pamamagitan ng maayos na rehabilitation at maging sa pag-promote sa sports. Hanggang ngayon po, sa kakaikot ko po sa buong Pilipinas, isa rin po ako sa author at co-sponsor ng National Academy of Sports. Iniinganyo ko talaga mga kabataan to get into sports, stay away from drugs, to keep us healthy and fit. This approach is also in line with the trust of this administration that attention must be also directed towards the rehabilitation and recovery of victims. Apart from the accessibility of facilities, ito po ay napaka-importante. Sana po ay magtulungan tayo dito. We also have to look into the process to be admitted to these centers. Currently, a commitment order from the court is required to be admitted to rehab centers. Marami pong mga drug user ang gustong magpa-rehab, pero napakahaba po ng proseso. Kaya kadalasan, naisip nila na huwag na lang magpa-rehab. Ang resulta, try to heal as to heal on their own. Walang intervention, bahala na. Kailangan nating ayusin ito dahil time is of the essence sa mga gustong magbagong buhay. We also have to look into mandatory counseling for victims and empower DSWD to help victims of this societal ill. As chairman of the Senate Committee on Youth, I also suggest crafting laws that would include in the school curriculum the knowledge and information necessary to prevent vices such as illegal drugs. We, as legislators, must work together to prevent abuse of power and protect and respect and uphold human rights. I have consistently worked to increase the budget for the operations of the Philippine National Police and the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Our efforts must be geared towards fulfilling their mandate in accordance with the law. Gamitin natin po ang investigasyong ito at hearing na ito upang siguraduhin walang pang-abusong mangyayari tungo sa ating isang hangarin na labanan po ang droga. I urge both houses of Congress, magtulungan po tayo dito. Kilala niyo po ako. I am committed to developing accessible rehabilitation centers for individuals facing drug addiction, and I am more so dedicated to ensuring the protection of and respect for human rights. Again, I am one with this committee in finding out the truth in the hopes that we could craft meaningful legislation for our beloved citizens. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Senator Bongo. Senator Cynthia Villar said that she will no longer deliver an opening statement. So I gave her time to you, actually, Senator BG. So. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, there are 8 senators present, 7 physically, 1 virtually. So we have overwhelming quorum to proceed with our hearing. And my dear colleagues, I gave you some simple ground rules beforehand. So I hope we can comply with the simple ground rules that your chairman is requesting all of us to observe. So at this point, at this point we will ask the committee secretary now to acknowledge and make of record the resource persons and or witnesses present this morning, and afterwards to immediately administer the oath to all of them. Committee Secretary, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The following resource persons or witnesses are present. Former President of the Republic of the Philippines, yeah. Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Former Senator Leila De Lima, former Chairman of Dangerous Drugs Board, Catalino Cui. Chief of Hospital, DOH Drug Abuse Treatment and Rehabilitation Centers, Dr. Jose Liabres. From DSWD, Kevin Bumagat, Chairperson of Commission on Human Rights, Attorney Richard Palpal Latok, retired General Romeo Karamat Jr., Inspector General of Internal Affairs Service, Attorney Brigido De Jesus Dulay, Lieutenant Colonel Jovi Espinido, from Davao City Police Office, Colonel Lito Patay. From PNP Drug Enforcement Group, Colonel Hector Grijaldo. Also present is Major Emil Garcia, former PNP Chiefs, retired General Archie Francisco Gamboa, retired General Debold Sinas, retired General Vicente D. Danau, former PIDEA Director General Aaron Aquino, former Presidential Legal Counsel and Presidential Spokesperson Attorney Salvador Panelo, former Chairman of Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission Mr. Greco Belhica, former Mayor of Iloilo City Jed Patrick Mabilog, Chairman of Free Legal Assistance Group Attorney Jose Chel Diocno, founder of Program Paghihilom Father Flaviano Villanueva, widow of Joselito Gonzalez, Miss Christina M. Gonzalez, representative of the parents of Kian Santos, Mr. Randy De Los Santos. That's all, Mr. Chair.
Can we proceed with the administration of the oath?
Major Chair?
Wait a minute, please.
Before we administer the oath, may we know if Kerwin Espinosa was invited?
Sige, ganito muna. Let's administer the oath to all those present and then let's now inventory who we invited and did not appear. Yung panggawin natin. Sige.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Please administer the oath.
Kindly stand up to all our resource person. Kindly raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this proceeding? For the record, Mr. Chair, everyone answered in affirmative.
Thank you. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. Okay, Committee Secretary, may mga tanong din kami. Sino ang ating inimbitahan na hindi naman pumunta ngayong umaga?
We invited retired Colonel Royina Garma. She sent a request to allow her to avail of the granted medical leave furlough approved by the Honorable Quad Committee.
Okay, and next, sino pa?
Yes, we also invited Edilberto Leonardo, but currently he is infected with COVID-19. We also invited Gerardo Padilla, but we did not get any reply. Padilla, sir, former director of the Directorate for Reformation.
But he got our invitation. Is that confirmed?
Your Honor, there's no acknowledgement. But we sent our invitation.
Sige, so who's the, meron pa ba? From, sino pa?
We also invited General Oscar Albayalde, former PNP Chief Guillermo Eleazar, and also General Leonardo Carlos. Kerwin Espinosa, sorry, Your Honor, we sent our letter, but no reply.
So with that, Mr. Chair, may I put on record that next hearing, these people should be required to attend.
Yes. Hindi pa yata tapos. Go ahead.
Sino we pa? Also invited retired General La Peña and retired General Wilkins Villanueva. They promised to attend the next hearing, sir.
Are you sure you're comprehensive in your list?
Yes, sir.
Sino pa? Ayan na?
Not yet, sir.
Ayan, not
we
yet.
Also
okay,
invited Mr. Guban. However, he just received the letter today and he is under the custody of House of Representatives. And then we also invited Mr. Kerwin Espinosa. Yes, but we cannot locate his address yet. So we will seek the help of PNP also. And that's it, sir.
Are you sure that's it?
Sir, we also invited Ermina Espino, but we cannot locate her address.
Mr. Chair, May I know the reason why Mr. Guban is not around?
He just received the letter today.
He just received the letter today.
Yes, Your Honor. We sent the letter to Quadcom of House of Representatives.
Mr. Chair, may I ask the Comsec, how can you not Espinosa when he attended the hearing in the Quad Commission, Quad Committee?
Your Honor, we asked the Quadcom Committee Secretary for his address, but he did not reply.
Who did not reply?
The Quadcom Committee Secretary.
Mr. Chair, I would rather that next hearing we have to require their presence, Mr. Chair, because I can only surmise with their absence that they don't want their statements that they have given before the House of Representatives to be debunked before this body, Mr. Chair. Ayaw nilang lumabas ang katotohanan kapag ayaw nilang pumunta dito. So that's it. That's my only observation, Mr. Chair.
Thank Mr. Chair.
Yes,
I just would like to amend the motion of Senator Bato that we issue a subpoena duces tecum against all those who were invited but did not attend in the today's hearing.
A correction daw, Ma'am Espino is here?
Yes, sir.
Emina, so okay. So, testificando. Yes, okay, ganito.
I'm sorry.
Okay, ganito gawin natin, okay? It has been manifested that Mr. Guban is under the custody of the House.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, they should have allowed him to attend. He has been requested by Senator Bato kasi to be here. So, the two others under the custody of the House are sick. Isa with COVID-19, isa undergoing a previously scheduled important medical procedure or examination. So we understand, we are reasonable people. Doon lang ako nagtaka kay Mr. Jerry Guban, bakit hindi siya pwede if he is under the custody of the House? How come the House did not allow us to have him here before us, my colleague? So anyway, at any rate, the remedy of this committee, as suggested by my colleagues, is the issuance of a subpoena to all
subpoena of... Subpoena, yes, at testificandum. Okay. I stand corrected, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Siguro, and we appeal to the House that for those people that they know the addresses of it, share the address. Share the address of these people. And then, of course, the committee will also exert utmost efforts to find these people and get their addresses. So, ganun na muna. In the meantime, my dear colleagues, ganun, we issue a subpoena to all those in the original list of invitees
we will
na
comply,
hindi
Your
pumunta
Honor.
Ngayon.